Now this model question is based on the earthquake formations, right? So there's a chance that, you know, since earthquakes and volcanoes and such events, such geophysical events which are in news, so there's a tendency there, or there's a chance that UPSC might ask questions related with these, you know, geophysical phenomena. Okay, so in that perspective, here a statement is given: the distribution and origin of most of the earthquakes coincide with plate boundaries. So they are saying the distribution and origin is related with or coinciding with the plate boundaries. And the occurrence of which of the following earthquakes validate the above given statement? So they are being asked that they have already said like the earthquake is formed or coincides with the plate boundaries. And you are being asked which of the following earthquakes formed over the plate boundaries. Here it's given as which of the following earthquakes validate the above given statement. In other words, you can say which of these earthquakes formed over the plate boundaries, right? Now let's have a look at the earthquake distribution and the plate boundaries. Here you can see different plates as well as the red dot represents the distribution of earthquake, right? Here you can see Pacific plate converging with the North American plate and the entire region, right? Here we are prone to earthquakes. Plus, they are converging with the South American plate as well as the divergent plate boundaries of North Atlantic Ridge. Okay, and another region is the Indo-Australian plate is converging with the Eurasian plate. The entire Himalayan Alpine Belt region is heavily prone to earthquakes. Okay, so in effect, you can see throughout the plate boundaries, the earthquakes are distributed, right? So you are being asked which of the given earthquakes are not formed over these plate boundaries, which one is the odd one, that is being asked, right? So before going to that, let's see some relationship between, or let's see some different kinds of plate boundaries. So mainly there are three kinds of plate boundaries. Plate in the sense the crustal region, the rock slab that we call test plate. And as far as the theory of plate tectonics, according to the theory of plate tectonics, the plates, they drift, right? Earlier it was believed like the continents was one who is drifting above the oceans. But now we know that it's not the continents that are moving, rather the plates which are moving, right? And this plates, it can include both continents in it as well as oceanic floor in it, right? Anyway, so the entire the earth is divided into different plates which are rock slab. So obviously these plates will be sharing boundary with each other. So there are three main kind of, there are broadly there are three kinds of boundaries, which are divergent, convergent and transform boundaries, right? So the divergent boundary, from the name itself, two plates are moving apart, that we call it as divergent boundary, which results in the topographical features like ridges or rift valleys. You must have heard about this African Rift Valley. We are having plates moving apart, right? At the Mid-Atlantic Ridge, the plates are moving apart. Here, the plates are moving apart, resulting in the ridge formations, right? And the next boundary is convergent. Again, the literal meaning, convergent, converging. So when two plates collide with each other, such kind of boundaries we call it as convergence. So there, instead of new crustal regions being formed, convergent boundary, we'll be having subduction taking place. The denser plate will always subduct under the other less denser plate, the lighter plate. Okay. So if you are having divergence, what happens is that the magma will be coming out towards the surface, forming new crustal regions that we call it as spreading zone. And if you are having two plates converging, having convergent boundary, the denser plate will subduct, which will get converted into magma, right? In both regions, we will be having earthquakes. Plus, transform boundary, the third kind of boundary, right? So, in transform boundary, it is not getting diverged, nor it is getting converged. Rather than they are moving parallel to each other. That we call it as lateral sliding, right? So, in that case also, we will be having the earthquake formation. Here, the distribution of earthquake plate boundaries as well as the volcanoes, they are related. So, over the divergent and convergent boundary, we would be able to find this volcanic distribution also. But volcanoes are absent over the transform boundary. And like this, transform boundary results in the formation of earthquakes. So that's the difference between the distribution of earthquake as well as the volcano. So remember that, right? The transform boundary will only be having earthquake, and in transform boundary the volcanoes are absent and only we will be having the earthquakes. But the earthquakes, they are present over all the three boundaries, right? Now the four regions given in the question, right? First one, Kathmandu. So let's go back to the question first. So the question was, which of the given earthquakes are over the plate boundaries, right? So the given options are Sumatra, Kathmandu, Chiapas and Bhuj earthquake. So let's go to the location of these regions. So Kathmandu is over the Nepal, right? The last earthquake, major earthquake in the Himalayan region took place over the Nepal, right? The epicenter or where it formed was Kathmandu, which is lying over the plate boundary. The Indian-Australian plate is converging with the Eurasian plate, and in that convergence zones we are having Kathmandu. Same way the Sumatra, right? Sumatra is over the Indonesian regions, which resulted in the 2004 tsunami, which wreaked havoc over the eastern coast of India, right, as well as some part of the western coast. So the Sumatra over the Indonesian region is also lying over the plate boundary. The next one is Chiapas. Okay, now Chiapas, the importance why that region is being asked in this model question, the reason being, like recently in Mexico, right, in the year 2007, Mexico witnessed two major earthquakes, which resulted in large number of casualties, right? More than 300 people died in these earthquakes, and one of the earthquakes which formed over the Chiapas, and this Chiapas is also over the plate boundaries, right? The minor plate, which is Cocos plate, is converging here, and which results in the earthquake, right? The next option given in the question were Bhuj. So in India's case, the Bhuj region, they are lying over the Gujarat, and this region witnessed one of the major earthquakes in the past. Okay, but the Bhuj earthquake or the Bhuj region is not over the plate boundary, right? Here, like over in these regions, we are having the Bhuj regions, and this was the epicenter of one of the major earthquakes which struck India, right? But it is not lying over the plate boundary. So now going back to the question, so as you might be knowing, among the options Sumatra, Kathmandu, Chiapas and Bhuj earthquake, Bhuj is not over the plate boundary, right? So you can eliminate four among the options. So you can eliminate C as well as B. Okay, so C and B being eliminated, what left is A as well as D. And from that, what's the inference? From that we understand that the 2 and 3, they are correct, right? So because 2 and 3 is both in the options, so it should be, it all depends on now whether the first one is correct, which is Sumatra earthquake. You must be knowing, as the Sumatra earthquake resulted in 2004 tsunami, they are lying over the Indonesia and they are lying over the plate boundaries. So in effect, the Sumatra validates the statement given here, which is saying that the earthquake formations coincide with the plate boundaries. So one is also correct, right? So answer here comes out as A, 1, 2 and 3, right? Here the Bhuj earthquake is the odd one, it is not lying over the plate boundary.